That M&W towing box machine, that's going to be Cameron Wilson. Going to be able to chase him. That's going to be the 92 of Matthew Hopper. So lap number one for Wilson, going to be a 14.856. As Matt Hopper, going to be a 14.991. 14.991. As Wilson, going to slow off on lap number two just a little bit. Matt Hopper has a chance at it here. Not going to be enough. 14.860. 14.860 for Matt Hopper. So Chris Wilson going to be out in the halo back to number 11. That's going to be the 62 of Brian Sievers. Wilson going to ramrod the top side out of turn four. He's going to hit the strap on lap number one. He'll go top of the board. 14.396. 14.396. As Brian Sievers going to be at 15.148. 15.148. Chris Wilson once again making his way down Main Street. He's going to clock out of his qualifying session even faster. 14.375. 14.375 for the 11 of Chris Wilson. Your next two pair of qualifiers are going to be coming out on the racing surface. That's the CNC Collision back number 29C. In that impressive race car, he was second fastest in hot laps a little bit ago. As he's got some ground to make up, as he's trying to set that machine on the front row for tonight's feature event. And going to be going to chase him. That's going to be the best one tire back to number one of Joey Wittenberg. Thunder cars, you need to be in staging. Thunder, you need to be in staging, guys. Lap number one for Cotterman, going to go second quick, 14.402. 14.402, less than a tenth off of your quick time, as he's going to rim ride the top side of round one and two. As Wittenberg, he'll go fifth quick. Joey Cotterman going to have a shot at it here, not going to be enough. He will slow off quite a bit from lap number one. Wittenberg going to remain fifth quick. So right now, it's Chris Wilson, Joey Cotterman, Cameron Wilson, Matt Hopper, and Joey Wittenberg, your top five. So your next two out, that's going to be the 88 of Adam Wright, going to be in the 88. Then it's going to be the other half of the Cotterman clan. It's the CNC Collision back number 28C of Jeff Cotterman. You see this racing groove starting to move up the high banks of Crossville Speedway. As Adam Wright going to go third quick, 14.812, 14.812. As Jeff Cotterman, third quick, with a 14.555, 14.555. Adam Wright going to try to advance, not going to be enough, 14.790, 14.790. Jeff Cotterman going to try to show the young buck how to get it done, not going to be enough, 14.404. Talk about two race cars that are almost identical. Joey Cotterman's lap time, 14.402. Jeff Cotterman's lap, 14.404. Less than two thousandths off of each other. So here we go with your next pair out. That's going to be the 01 of Chris Payne. Going to be giving chase to him. That's the Midas of Cookville backs. 5M of Scott Shelton. Scott Shelton here has picked up two feature wins on the 2022 season. Chris Payne going to go eighth quick, 15.019, 15.019. Scott Shelton going to hit the strap on lap number one. Fourth quick, 14.460, 14.460. Is Chris Payne going to remain ninth quick? At that lap time, going to be a 15-179. Scott Shelton going to try his luck on lap two. Still going to remain fourth quick with a 14-460. So here we go, your next pair. You're going to be the 49K of Kurt Turner. I'm going to be giving chase to him. That's Justin Maxwell in the T20. That's Kurt Turner. Lap number one for him. Going to be fifth quick. 14-499. 14-499. Maxwell will be 10th. 10th quick. 15-010. 15-010. That's Turner. He's going to hit the stripe on lap number two, 14-677. He'll slow off about two-tenths from lap number one. As Maxwell going to try to improve on lap number two, not going to be enough. 15-499 on lap number two. So your top five right now, it's going to be Chris Wilson, Joey Carterman, Jeff Carterman, Scott Shelton, and Kurt Turner. As we've got three remaining in the chute. Thunder cars, you need to be in staging. Thunder, you need to be in staging. As Justin Parker now going to be on the clock, going to be giving chase to him. That is the Loftus Underground back number 70 of A.J. Garber. A.J. Garber, no stranger here to the high banks of Crossville Speedway, picked up many feature wins in the past. As Parker going to go 15-294. That'll be good enough for 13th quick. Garber going to go 14-965. 14-965, good enough for 10th quick so far. Parker going to remain 14th quick, as Garber as well going to remain 10th quick, 14-960. All of these guys are getting their fastest laps on lap number one. And last but not least, good looking ride here, the 99, the Dreamscapes, that machine of Shannon Elrod. Shannon Elrod went from the late model world back to the open wheel modifieds. As his laptop number one had some troubles there, that's going to hurt his first qualifying lap. Well, 16-038, 16-038. As lap number two, you're going to be faster, but not enough. 15th quick for Shannon Elrod, 15-448. So your quick time belonging to the Halo backs, number 11 of Chris Wilson. Joey Cotterman going to be second. Jeff Cotterman going to be third. Scott Shelton and Kurt Turner are going to round out your top five. So we're going to go green in your street stock feature event. So Brian Hamby going to lead us down the back straightaway.
Oh. Blew my papers.
So we're going to be four laps into this feature event. Brian Hamby leading the way. It's going to be Scotty Proffitt, Pete Wright, Jeff Proffitt, As we're coming around, 5 and 10 to go. So we're going to be nearing lap number 10 as we're going to hit 9 as we cross the stripe this time. 6 laps remaining. Brian Hamby still leading the way.
Might as well.
So race fans, he's going to climb out of this hot rod all the way from Wartburg, Tennessee. He's going to sling his butts off, take the neck brace off, give it up for the 32 of Brian Hamby. So Brian, it's your second win here at Crossville Speedway. You came out, started on the pole, never looked back, man. Take us through some of that.
Well, I knew I had some real good competition here with the what I call the hometown boys, the prophets around me, the bad fast P ride. I call it the Camaro wagon behind me. I mean, the man wins everywhere he goes, so I knew I had some stiff competition. This year's just been one to remember, bad luck everywhere we look, so this has just been an upside for us, so we're gonna take it for sure.
Absolutely, absolutely. Take it into the next one. Who's some of these sponsors that get you up and down the road each week and parking here in Victory Lane tonight?
Oh, man, I can't thank everybody that's on this car. Starting right here, Mike Knuckles at Warrior 1G Shock Service. Man, these shocks are amazing. As you can see, the car was, it looked like it could flip over at any minute. I know it felt like it could, but it got me to this point. Nelson Farms, that's where I keep this old hot rod at, is and a cow field. I mean, it's right there. Outlaw Graphics here in Crossville, Tennessee, making this car look good. Mike Vaden at Vaden Race Engines giving me a power plant. CNC Collision and Towing. Joey and Jeff Cardman, they're coming up in this open wheel feature. I want y'all to root for them. Please do so. So They helped me out a bunch. Can't thank them enough. Doug Smith, the Double H Race Fabrication, for all my bumper needs, my door bar needs. It's just amazing.
Absolutely. And Joey and Jeff are going to be starting second and third on the field tonight. So give it up one more time for the 32 of Brian Hamby picking up tonight's Street Stock feature event. So here we go with your modifieds. Your front row is going to be the 11 of Chris Wilson and Joey Carterman. Then the row number two, that's going to belong to Jeff Carterman, and the 5M of Scott Shelton. Then you got Kurt Turner, Adam Wright, Cameron Wilson, and Matt Hopper, Joey Wittenberg, and A.J. Garber. As we're going to be coming out as turn number four, we're going underway. Green flag in the air. Here we go. So you know these guys, we're watching the crate race, watching where the race is going to have to be ran, either the top, bottom, or the middle. Has the yellow flag going to come out? Race command not liking that start. So we're going to line up two by two once again. Wilson and Carterman going to be your front row. As they're going to ease off into turn number three. But out of turn number four, we're going to get underway. As Wilson laid back on that one. Joey Carterman quickly going to go to the top side. Looks like the 5M Scott Shelton going to follow suit. Jeff Carterman going to slide up in front of Scott. Scott now going to try to work his way around the 20 ACF. Jeff Carterman. We got Kirk Turner and Adam Wright going side by side. So we've got them stretched out all through the front of the field, but the battle is going to be, the closest one on the racetrack is going to be between the 92 and the 70 of Garber. Wilson putting about a half a straightaway on the rest of the field. Then you got Joey Carterman, Jeff Carterman, Scott Shelton. Shelton's going to go way up top right there on the cushion. As we got a car slowed at the top of turn number four, it looks like it might belong to the five of Cameron Wilson. So while we got just a little bit of a break in the action, got to say a huge 18th birthday to Abby Weaver. Abby, you could have been anywhere else in the world, but you're a Weaver, and I know you'd spend it right here at Crossville Speedway. So for that, we'd like to wish you a very happy birthday. As we're going to get ready to go back underway in your open modifieds, Wilson going to be on the front row of this Delaware double file restart. Then you got a father and son duo in your second row. As we're going to go back underway, Carterman going to be on the top side. So Scott Shelton and Turner getting a little bump in action, going down the back straightaway. Shelton then looks like he's going to get the better end of the deal. As Turner, going to be about half a car behind. That's going to put Scott Shelton up to fourth. Shelton now going to try a different approach down the bottom side. He's going to try to look his way around the 28 of Jeff Carterman. So the 49K of Turner, a slow on the back straightaway. Looks like we're going to stay clean and green. Turner going to pull that hot rod down to the infield pit. It's going to bring his night to an end. So Joey Kahneman off the pace. You seen him make a mistake over the top of turn number two. He's got to make you what's going on with that impressive race car. As he's got his, that thing back under power. As Jeff Kahneman got the same deal going on. What is going on in turn? Oh, there's a drive shaft in turn number two. So here we go, Leafs fans. It's 10 laps in, 10 to go, halfway home in this 20-lap feature event. Chris Wilson has led it from the green flag so far. Jeff Kahneman, then you've got the 5 of Scott Shelton. We go back underway. Scott Shelton going to take a peek underneath the 28 of Jeff Kahneman. Jeff Kahneman going to use the top side with that momentum. As we've got one looped around once again over in turn number four. So we got them back lined out, nose to tail. We got back underway. As we have the domino effect there just a little bit, that's going to catch that 70 of AJ Garber. Off guard now. Here we go. Scott's going to try to look underneath the 28 of Kahneman. Once again, not going to get it done. Joey Kahneman going to play chase. Adam Wright going to step up to the top shelf here. Try to make his way around the 29. They almost make contact. Wow. You probably couldn't have fit a couple of pieces of paper between the 88 and the 29 that time around. Scott Shelton and Jeff Kahneman duking it out. Shelton trying the bottom side, trying the top side, trying to find the best way around. As Jeff Kahneman just staying mighty steady right there in the middle. But meanwhile, that's allowing the 11 of Wilson to drive out of the rest of the fields. As the 01 going to loop it around over in turn number four. We're going to go back underway. Scott Shelton still trying to get underneath the 28 of Jeff Kahneman. Has the 88 of Pete Wright. No, not Pete Wright, Adam Wright. Now found a head of steam around the top side of Crossville Speedway. Adam Adam Ragg going to use that momentum. Apple turn number two, almost making contact with five analyst Scott Shelton. Joey Cotterman making his way back up to the field. A.J. Garber now going to step up to the top shelf as well. But meanwhile, that's allowing the 11 of Wilson once again to put as much distance in between him and the number two man of Cotterman as he possibly can. 17 in the books, 18 this time by. It's going to be white flag in the air this time for Wilson. One more lap around Crossville Speedway, and he will take home tonight's open wheel modified feature event. Alpha turn number four, Chris Wilson going to take home the open wheel modifieds, followed by Jeff Cotterman, Scott Shelton, and Pete Wright. Supers. Sure. Yeah. He raced here in a while, man. Yeah, he raced here quite a bit. So here we go with your dwarf car feature event. Dustin Dunlap with us off turn number four. Dakota Richards getting a heck of a run off of turn number two, as now Dunlap's going to have some company from the 57. This is going to be a scheduled 15 lap feature event. Dakota Richards, no stranger to victory lane around here. Dustin Dunlap. Dustin Dunlap has had feature wins here as well. He's also had a little bit of bad luck right on the front straightaway, as he had a pretty nasty crash a couple years back. He's gathered that thing back together, and he is putting on an absolute spectacle. But here comes the 14 of Mike Brown. Mike Brown wants to join the party, as now he's going to be up behind the 57 of Dakota Richards. So it looks like the 17 of Todd Clark loops it around over in turn number four. Looks like he might be stuck down there in the mud. Might need a pool. So here we go. We're going back underway. Dustin Dunlap with a lead off of turn number four. Mike Brown. We're going to try to begin a chase to your race leader. The 57 of Dakota Richards and Hunter Rich going to go at it out. No, that's going to be the 20 of Collier. folks. Here we are. We are 11 laps into this 15-lap feature event. Dustin Dunlap still continuing to lead. Then it's Mike Brown, Dakota Richards, and the 20 of Collier are going to be your top four. So 13 laps in, Bullhorn's going to be in the air. Dustin Dunlap looking to pick up your dwarf car feature event. Mike Brown going to be running second still. Then you get the 57, Dakota Richards. White flag going to be in the air this time by. It is going to be one more rotation around Crossville Speedway for Dustin Dunlap. So Dunlap's going to pick up your dwarf car feature event. David Dunlap picks it up, as he's no stranger to victory lane here at Crossville. Mike Brown going to be second, Dakota Richards, and the 20 of Collier. So here we go with your still here late models. You got the 617 of Colton Prophet and the 15 of Michael Smith. Going to be on your front row. Then you got the 16 of DeLong and the 49 of Jeff Walker.
Oh, I thought that would get better.
Colton Prophet going to try the bottom side. He's going to slide up toward the top of the racetrack. It's going to allow the 15 to be in behind. As Michael Smith looking for his first still here late model feature event. They're going to be nose to tail, and it's going to be Colton Prophet, Michael Smith, Jeff Walker. Then you got Bradley. You got the 16 of DeLong. So you got a three-way battle back there for your number four spot. Has a 17, almost going to make contact. Has to get in the binders, and that's going to cause a chain reaction. It's going to allow the 413 of Jonathan Denton to loop it around over in turn number four. Caution is out. So we get the one to go sign from our official flagman that time by Colton Prophet. I'm going to be on the front row of this Delaware double file restart. Fixing to go back underway. Three in the books. 20 going to be the scheduled distance. We go back underway. So the 709 going to loop it around over in turn number two.
Jesus.
So here we go, we're going to go back underway. Colton Prophet going to lead us off the turn number four once again. Three laps in, 17 remain in this 20-lap feature event. So Michael Smith still continuing to hunt down your leader as we got a couple of them looped together over in turn number two. Caution will wave once again. Looks like it's going to be the 412 of Tracy Denton this go around. So we got them back into the Delaware Double File restart formation. Michael Smith and Jeff Walker going to be on your first four rows. We're going to get underway. Jeff Walker got a good run off of turn number two. He's going to try to take a stab at your number two man, Michael Smith. As that is allowing the 617 of Colton Prophet to pull away. Michael Smith going to be running second. Jeff Walker going to be third and DeLong running in your top four. as the 413 of Jonathan Denton loops it around once again over in turn number two. Caution will wave. So quickly back into formation. Here we go off turn number four. Once again, five in, 15 to go. So we're nose to tail, but we got the 16 DeLong going to battle with the 17 for the number four spot. Jonathan Denton once again around in turn four. So here we go, back underway. Colton Provis still showing the way, seven in. 20 is our scheduled distance. So we're going to put some laps on the board right here. The yellow number one going to step up to the top side of the racetrack, thinks there's something there. So we got 10 in, 10 to go, 20 laps our scheduled distance. We've got them spread out nose to tail. Colton Proffitt still showing the way. So 15 down, 5 to go. Colton Proffitt still staying on the straight and narrow. As long as he can keep them wheels underneath him, he will look looking to pick up tonight's steelhead feature event, front wheel drive. You need to be in the chute. The white flag going to be displayed this time by Colton Proffitt. May have a little bit of an issue with lap traffic, but he's going to dive down to the bottom side. Looks like he's going to clear Tracy Denton. He'll pick up tonight's steelhead feature event, followed by the 15 of Michael Smith, and then the 49 of Jeff Walker, rounding out your top three. So here we go, Jacob Sharp and Amelia McLean, your front row, Dustin Duncan, Cody Rector. As we're going to go underway, front wheel drive style. You have got a four-way battle for your race lead. Amelia McLean is showing the way. Jacob Sharp, Dustin Duncan, Cody Rector, and Mikey Jones going to be your top five so far. As Cody Rector looking to look underneath the 21 of Dustin Duncan, can't seem to get it done just yet. It is nose to tail all the way around as Amelia McLean has to know that Jacob Sharp is back there. Jacob Sharp picked up many feature wins in the last handful of years here at Crossville Speedway. Knows his way around the high banks. So Jacob Sharp, you see him having to get in the binders just a little bit to keep from making contact with your race leader, Amelia McLean. So Dustin Duncan trying to make his way around your number two man of Jacob Sharp. So Jacob Sharp going to step out of line, try to make a move on the inside. He's going to go to the bottom side. Amelia McLean's got the momentum around the top. Who's going to lead? Lap number seven. Amelia McLean still has Dustin Duncan trying to take up your number two spot. Jacob Sharp stepped out of line, hoping to make a move, but couldn't seem to get it down there, door-to-door, down the back straightaway. Dustin Duncan, Jacob Sharp, Cody Rector sitting back, waiting for his chance to strike. As lap traffic may pose a problem for your top four, and Cody Rector throws the needle, as now Amelia McLean and Cody Rector are engaged, so this might get interesting. We'll see who's going to be nice and who's not. I would hate, or actually, I would love to be a fly on the wall tonight in the Rector household when they go home and talking about this. As Jacob Sharp gives Cody Rector a little bit of a love tap, that's going to allow him to get a little bit loose. Jacob Sharp trying to take it back over, can't seem to find the momentum of a turn number four. We're 11 laps in, four to go. Is Cody Rector going to push his fiance to a victory, or is he going to take over the race lead? As Cody Rector giving Amelia a little bit of a tap out of turn number three, as they're going to split the difference, Amelia McLean chose the bad line right there, has to get in the brakes. She's going to try it again, take it back over the number two spot from Jacob Sharp there, door to door, into turn number three. But Cody Rector, your new race leader. White flag in the air. Amelia McLean going to slip back to third now. She's got some company from the 21 of Dustin Duncan. As Jacob Sharp, it's going to be a battle for the win. Jacob Sharp looks to go to the bottom. It's going to be a quick slide job. Does he have the momentum? No. Cody Rector going to take home your front-wheel drive feature event. Followed by the one of Jacob Sharp, Dustin Duncan, Amelia McLean. And looks like it's going to be the 13 of Ryan Harness.
later, please.
So Clarissa Stewart going to be on the front row inside of this as the race is scheduled for 15 laps. We go underway. Green flag is out. So the white flag going to be displayed this time as the caution flag will wave as the 716 looks like he had parked that thing down into the infield and a turn number four.